I'm Prashant S. Malge, Assistant Professor, Department of Electronics Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today we'll see how to design a FIR filter using windowing technique. The learning outcome. At the end of this session, student will be able to design a FIR filter using windowing technique. Now consider an example for this. Design a low pass filter with desired frequency response given by HD e raised to j omega equal to e raised to minus 2j omega from minus pi by 4 to plus pi by 4, 0 from mod omega between pi by 4 to pi. Determine the filter coefficients h of n if the window function is given as wn equal to this, and also determine the frequency response h e raised to j omega of the desired filter. Here this hd, d stands for desired frequency response. Now let us plot the magnitude of this particular frequency response. That is magnitude of hd e raised to j omega. If you look at here, the magnitude between minus pi by 4 to plus pi by 4 is 1. So if I consider the response from minus pi by 4 pi to plus pi, so the magnitude of this particular frequency response is 1 from minus pi by 4 to plus pi by 4, and this mod omega between pi by 4 to pi means the response is 0 from minus pi to minus pi by 4, and also it is 0 from plus pi by 4 to pi. Now for this we want to design the filter. So the next step is to determine the desired impulse response from HD e raised to j omega. So this is obtained by taking the inverse Fourier transform of HD e raised to j omega. So where it is written as HDN is equal to 1 upon 2 pi minus pi to pi HD e raised to j omega e raised to j omega n d omega. So we obtain this inverse Fourier transform. Now if you look at this particular response, the magnitude response is 0 from minus pi to this minus pi by 4. It is equal to 1 from minus pi by 4 to pi by 4, and it is equal to 0 from once again pi by 4 to pi. So we'll divide this integral between three different ranges, and with that we can write this integral as HDN is equal to minus pi by 4, sorry, minus pi to minus pi by 4 HD e raised to j omega e raised to j omega n d omega. So I'll take this 1 upon 2 pi outside, plus minus pi by 4 to plus pi by 4 HD e raised to j omega e raised to j omega n d omega plus pi by 4 to pi HD e raised to j omega e raised to j omega n d omega. So if you look at in this range, that is from minus pi by 4 to plus minus pi to minus pi by 4, and from pi by 4 to pi, the magnitude of this particular frequency response is 0. So therefore these two integrals will be 0. So therefore HDN can be written as HDN is equal to 1 upon 2 pi integral from minus pi by 4 to plus pi by 4. Because in this range, the value of hd e raised to j omega n is e raised to minus 2j omega. Therefore, this is equal to e raised to minus 2j omega e raised to j omega n d omega. So, this can be obtained as 1 upon 2 pi minus pi by 4 to plus pi by 4 e raised to j omega n minus 2 d omega. So, by taking this integral, this is equal to e raised to j omega n minus 2 upon j n minus 2 minus pi by 4 to plus pi by 4. Substituting these limits, we can write this as 1 upon 2 pi e raised to j pi by 4 n minus 2 minus e raised to minus j pi by 4 n minus 2 divided by j n minus 2. So we know that e raised to j theta minus e raised to minus j theta divided by 2j. So this, taking this 2 and j, we can write this as 1 upon pi n minus pi n minus 2 into sine pi by 4 n minus 2. So this is what you get hdn for n not equal to 2. And when n equal to 2, because when n tends to 2, this becomes 0. So as we know that sine theta, theta tends to 0 equal to theta. So therefore, for n equal to 2, this sine will be equal to pi by 4 n minus 2, that cancel and it is equal to 1 by 4. So for n equal to 2. So therefore, with this, our desired impulse response hdn is equal to sine pi by 4 n minus 2 upon pi n minus 2 for n not equal to 2 and equal to 1 by 4 for n equal to 2. So we can obtain the coefficients by using this particular formula. Now we know that given window function is a rectangular window and it is defined as Wn equal to 1 for 0 to 4, 0 otherwise. So therefore, by multiplying by this window function with this hdn, we can obtain the impulse response of the design filter. So impulse response of design filter is h of n is equal to hdn into wn. So as this wn is equal to 1 between 0 to 4, 0 otherwise, so therefore hn will be equal to hdn 0 to 4, 0 otherwise. So the length of our filter will be only 5, that is, it exists only between 0 to 4. So therefore it is a FIR filter. So we can obtain the values of these filter coefficients by substituting this n in this particular equation. So therefore h of 0 is equal to hd 0, which is equal to, so if we substitute 0 here, so this is sine pi by 2 upon 2 pi. So this comes out to be 1 upon 2 pi. So if we substitute h of 1, which is equal to hd 1, where this comes out to be when n equal to 1, this is 1 minus 2 is minus 1, so sine minus pi by 4 upon pi, so sine upon minus pi, so minus gets cancelled, So what you get is 1 by root 2 pi. Same way, h of 2 is equal to 1 by 4. Now when you substitute n equal to 3, this comes out to be once again sin pi by 4 upon pi. So once again will be equal to hd1. So this is equal to h of 3. Same way when you substitute 4, this will be 4 minus 2. So sin pi by 2 upon 2 pi. So that comes out to be equal to h, this h of 0, that is 1 upon, or this is h of 4. So therefore, h of 0 equal to h of 4 equal to 1 by 2 pi, h of 1 equal to h of 3 equal to 1 by root 2 pi, and h of 2 equal to 1 by 2. So these are the filter coefficients. Using these filter coefficients, now we can obtain the frequency response h e raised to j omega of the design filter. So this can be obtained by h e raised to j omega equal to n equal to 0 to 4 h of n e raised to minus j omega n. So this is equal to h of 0 plus h of 1 e raised to minus j omega plus h of 2 e raised to minus 2 j omega plus h of 3 e raised to minus 3 j omega plus h of 4 e raised to minus 4 j omega. From this, by taking this e raised to minus 2 j omega common, this can be written as h of 0 into e raised to minus, oh sorry, plus 2 j omega plus h of 1 e raised to j omega plus h of 2 plus h of 3 e raised to minus j omega plus h of 4 e raised to minus 2 j omega. So as this h of 0 and h of 4 are values are same, so this can be written as this is 1 upon 2 pi e raised to 2j omega plus e raised to minus 2j omega divided by 2 if we take and multiply by 2. So this comes out to be 2 cos of 2 omega plus, same way these two are same, if you take common e raised to j omega plus e raised to minus j omega by 2, you will get cos. So 1 by root 2 pi into 2 cos omega plus h of 2 is 1 by 4. So therefore, this h e raised to j omega equal to e raised to minus 2 j omega in bracket 1 by 4 plus this 2 and root 2. So this is root 2 by pi cos omega plus 2 gets cancelled. So 1 by pi cos 2 omega. So this is the impulse response of the filter. This is how we can design the FIR filter by using windowing technique. These are the references.